Sylvia, Lochner said that Dix came here and described the murder of Mildred Atkinson. Did he?
We were both very impressed with his imagination. But why should that worry you? You know Dix didn't do it. You saw him after the girl left.
Of course. He hardly knew her. He had nothing against her.
That's what Brubb says.
I know. But Lochner has a different idea. He believes Dix could have done it. I left his office feeling as though he were trying to warn me.
Oh, don't pay any attention to Lochner.
You don't realize what he's doing to us. I suppose it isn't just Lochner. There is something strange about Dix, isn't there? I keep worrying about it. I stay awake nights trying to find out what it is. And then he shows up for breakfast with an armload of packages, and he's so sweet and so kind that he makes me feel...
Ashamed of what you've been thinking? Then why don't you talk to him? Tell him how you feel.
What can I say to him? I love you, but I'm afraid of you. I want to marry you, but first convince me that Lochner's wrong, that you didn't kill Mildred Atkinson.
You should go away for a while. I'd really think you should. I mean, give yourself a little time. Figure things out quietly. You're too anxious.
Sylvia, after we left you, Dix got into an argument with a man. He acted like a maniac. I thought he was going to kill him. I thought maybe he acted just the same with Mildred. I came here because I wanted to say these things out loud and be laughed at. But you're not laughing.
I still don't know who killed that check from the girl. This isn't going to be as easy to get out of as it was with Mr. Baker.
It was the act of a sick mind with an urge to destroy. An erratic, violent man. He's our most logical suspect. Killing has a fascination for him.
I wanted to say these things out loud and be laughed at. But you're not laughing.
Hey, going up to see Miss Gray?
Yeah, I'll take those up for you. Give me an excuse to see her.
You don't need an excuse. But I need a new pair of legs. Tell her I'll be back tomorrow with the rest of her things. Goodbye, Mr. Steele.
Bye, Mr. Swan. Oh, morning, Effie. Mm. Is Gray awake?
Mm-mm.
How many times do I have to tell you not to vacuum when she's sleeping?
She can't hear nothing. She takes pills.
Since when?
I don't know.
Hmm. Must have worked all night.
I wish you and Miss Gray would get married and go on a honeymoon. Then I could get these two apartments cleaned up.
Shut it off, honey, and go back to sleep.
I can't. The clock's too far away.
I'll shut it off for you if you want me to.
All right. Come in.
You want to go back to sleep?
No. I'll get up.
I'll start breakfast.
You might open the door for me.
Beg your pardon, Effie.
Thank you.
I'll do it, Dick.
No, I don't want you to. You sit down, be comfortable. Room service coming up.
What happened to the grapefruit knife?
Oh, it was crooked and I straightened it.
Cool. It's supposed to be curved.
What? Wonder what they'll think of next.
I finished the pages.
Yeah, I noticed you also covered the script. What are you trying to prove? You won't get a raise, you know.
I love the love scene. It's very good.
Well, that's because they're not always telling each other how much in love they are. A good love scene should be about something else besides love. For instance, this one. Me fixing grapefruit, you sitting over there dopey, half asleep. Anyone looking at us could tell we were in love. Effie wants us to get married. Says it'll give her a chance to vacuum the apartment while we're away.
Isn't there a simpler way?
I always knew I'd get stuck with you eventually. All I needed was a little push. Doctor.
A couple of weeks ago.
Why didn't I know about that?
I guess I didn't think it was important enough to mention. It's only lately that you've wanted to know everything about me.
Well, you ought to be very flattered that I do.
I am. And I love you. But there's no reason to rush into anything.
Well, who said anything about rushing into anything? I thought maybe if you'd give me an answer, say, in the next 10 seconds, go right out and buy a ring. And we could have a little engagement party tonight at Paul's, invite a few of our select friends and enemies, take a plane to Las Vegas around midnight and be married by...
The coffee.
Another 10 seconds are up.
Of course I'll marry you, but...
No. Of course, no but, no why. Yes or no will do. A simple yes or no will do very well.
Yes.
Effie, it's okay. You can vacuum tomorrow. Both apartments. Dix, wait, what's happened? Effie, you tell him.